Hi, everybody. We fooled you. It's the Rocksmith 2014 live stream, not frozen stream. Your video is working fine, except that it's displaying me, Dan Amrick, the community manager for Rocksmith 2014. And this week, as you can tell by the giant red logo behind us, it's Soundgarden week on our stream. We're going to be doing three songs from the recently released Soundgarden 5-pack. Some discussion about that people were surprised that was not one of the top 40 most requested artists. I was surprised about that too. But there you have it. They weren't that far off, honestly. We got plenty of requests for Soundgarden. And so, yeah, we're going to be doing three songs from that. Let's see, what else we got? Oh, we've got a Stone Cold classic that Greg Barr is going to come out and talk about for our backtrack this week. We're going to be doing Smoke on the Water by Deep Purple. And, yeah, I don't have anything else to say. And yes, look at our new set yet again. So if you're a longtime viewer of the stream, we messed some stuff up last week and we changed things around and we changed them immediately after we went off the air. We all went, that didn't work. Let's do it this way next week. So you may see some more variants, like for instance, David and Anthony here have the headset mics and I've got a hosty mic so that I can do this.
Hello.
But there's no point for me to do that because you have your own microphone. But thank you for taking the bait.
Thanks.
All right, so we'll play around with our fancy new toys, and why don't you take a look at the Soundgarden video. We've got a trailer that gives you a little snippet of all five songs. We're only going to do three today, so place your bets now after you watch the trailer. See which three we're going to do. I'll tell you that the first track we're going to do when we come back starts with S. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Well, there you have it. Five songs by Soundgarden. Which three will we play? Only you know, because I forgot. Actually, I think I'm supposed to play one this week. So that's not the best thing. Hey, everybody. Thanks for coming back. If you've just joined us, we will have plenty of giveaways and lots of fun things to do in the next hour. We've got some stuff to give away from Ernie Ball. We've got guitar and bass accessories in two different packs. We've also got some DLC codes for Steam players for that Soundgarden DLC. So you might be able to get all of that stuff yourself for free before the end of the hour. I want to shout out to Black Widow 9. She is our hostess today. You know her from the Rocksmith forums as well. She's the banhammer. But Jason was unavailable this week, and Black Widow said, I can step up. And so step up she did, so thanks for being out there. Be nice to her, because she's the person that's going to give you all that free stuff. And one other thing, old business. Last week, a lot of people said, why don't you guys get to be a partner site on Twitch? And so I reached out to Twitch, and I said, would that help our stream? They're like, yeah, we'll do that for you. So hopefully the stream is working a little bit better for those of you in faraway lands. I know that folks in like the west coast of America didn't have a lot of problems, but we were here in that you guys out in the UK and in European countries were having a bit more trouble. Hopefully that's better. I'll check in on the chat a little bit during this song. But this song, giving myself my own segue. Hi, Anthony Martinez. How are you?
Hello. I'm doing well.
Are you comfortable with your newfound power of having your own microphone?
I am.
Yeah? You feel more powerful than normal?
I think so.
You look more powerful. David Stevens, you're all powerful because you are a Q&A ninja.
Maniacal.
Yeah, you are a maniacal dictator of quality assurance. That's how I like to think about you. You guys are going
to
be doing
my signature in my email.
Oh yeah, yeah. You need all new business cards. Are you kidding me? So I promised that this song would start with S. Was I right? Is this Spoon Man?
Oh yeah.
It is.
Okay. Did you track this one?
I did not.
You did not.
I don't track.
You don't track. You just you point out other people's faults. That's what you do in QA. Yeah. No, I like to go negative because if you follow the internet, you know, nothing spreads quite like negativity.
Sure.
It spreads like butter. So why are you playing Spoon Man for us today then?
Because Matt Montgomery is out on vacation.
Oh, well, that's a darn good reason. So he tracked this.
He deserves it.
And Anthony, what made you want to step up and do Spoon Man today?
It's a great song.
That's a good enough reason for me. Anything that you guys want to say, I'm going to check the chat while you play, if that's okay. And, of course, now that you have mics, so if you want to swear into them when you make mistakes, please don't.
It'll
but you could do it. We don't have a five-second delay. Is there anything you want to say setting this up beforehand? Is this easy, medium, hard kind of in the world?
I would put
of
it medium.
Yeah?
It's drop D. A lot of people assume that's easy, but it's got some interesting shifting and a nice rhythm.
Okay. And
I think it's pretty tricky, especially on bass. You're constantly playing. There's a small break in the middle right before the Spoon Man solo. But, yeah, it's a test of endurance.
Okay. Well, you're on a short scale today. You're on one of our Epiphone EB3s, I think. It's an EB3. So you shouldn't have to travel quite as much. We have something from Jared over in the Peanut Gallery. Hi, Jared.
Saying that the headset mics are very quiet. I know these mics are pretty low, so you probably want to keep them pretty close to your mouth.
Don't be afraid. Yeah.
Testing.
Thank you for the feedback. Thanks for pointing out problems. Who are you, David Stevens? All right. Why don't you guys play this song, and we'll continue to tweak the tech as we go. But don't forget, we've got some Ernie Ball stuff to give away. We'll be giving away the Ernie Ball bass pack shortly after the song. And I will check in on the chat room and see if I can address anything in between the hot, awesome riffs from Soundgarden with Spoon Man. I got a question from the chat that said, what happened to Misty? That's a good question. We are still very good friends with Misty, of course, but Misty was volunteering her time while she had it, and then Misty went on to do some community work on a little game you might know called Far Cry 4. So that obviously keeps Misty way busy, and she no longer had the time to donate to our little Cowtown puppet show here. So Jason Paradise is our normal chat mod now. He's a big Rocksmith fan himself. And today he was unavailable. So we get the pleasure of Tawny's company today. But Misty's cool. You can still follow her. She's on Twitter at UBMisty. Jaguar Car 6 says he wishes that the lyrics were louder. It would take away from his guitar, but it would help cover up his mistakes when he plays. You can actually go into the game in the mixer and adjust your guitar level a little bit lower than the master recording, if you'd like. That is a possibility. You can bury your mistakes a little bit more if you'd like. So far. Oh, look at you! Look at you! Wish I could go close-up cam and get your spoons, man. This wasn't in the tracker. You didn't say you were gonna do that. That was worth it.
We deliver the full experience.
Yeah. Is the spoon transcribed for guitar? Asks the chat room. Spoonsmith confirmed. Yeah. We may change the name. Any point in asking about the original variant of Rocksmith, says Bitspiel. Depends on what you're asking about. The folks that made it are here in the room. We have moved on to Rocksmith 2014, so there's no plans to go back and update the original Rocksmith any further. If you have it, you know, it still works, and you can get the, owning it is going to be what you need to get the import pack, to bring all those songs, or most of those songs, I should say, not all, into Rocksmith 2014. But, yeah, if you were just looking for that to continue on as its own project, no, 2014 is here, and it's eaten the original's lunch. You handled that bass very well, because I was dangerously close to it. actually, thank you for cheating a little bit forward, because I did not feel threatened by your bass at all. Hey, you guys did quite well. Look at that, 83% and whatever. You got 90-something there. Yeah, 83 and 93.6. Sorry. Anything you want to throw in about performance? Things now that you've gone through it and it's fresh, and what do you... What do you recommend?
Spoons are much harder than the guitar.
Spoons are much harder than the guitar. I would believe that. Anything about the guitar or the bass that you feel is worth bringing up, or should we just keep on rolling on? You don't have to have crushing insight here. I'm offering.
I say we keep on rolling.
All right. Well, then we'll keep on rolling. And Anthony, you're gonna be on the Wheels of Steel, because Brian Pody, yeah, currently on the Wheels of Steel, is setting up the next song, but you're going to help us out. So any technical problems that you experience for the next 5-10 minutes, that's Anthony's fault, so that's good.
Speaking of which, you're on 4.
I'm on 4? And I told you I was on 1? Oh, I'm sorry. Is that why the level C?
You're trying to throw me a curveball.
No, I'm not trying to throw you. I'm trying to screw up Pody, because I was like, I just switched all the mic cables on our mixer just to see if he would notice, and unfortunately he did. So yeah, sorry about that, Brian. Why don't you come on in here and play us a song, sir? David, thank you very much. Keep those bugs at bay. And, oh yes, Jared McAdams coming in. Oh yeah! Coming in from the side. So yeah, guys, we'll be doing a little live Q&A segment later in the We'll be doing a live Q&A segment later on in the show. So if you have any specific questions that I can't, you know, I might not be able to see them in real time because a lot of times I'm talking to these guys or I'm blowing my nose. I am pretty sick. There's a big bug going around the San Francisco Bay Area, and I am sadly hosting it. Let us know. Keep them in mind, and then when I call out for questions later on, I'll do it. I should give you a little update on Xbox 360 licenses. We were talking to Microsoft again this week, trading data, trying to figure it out. We still don't have an ETA and no progress to share with you, but that does not mean that we're not making progress. It's just that, you know, honestly, when that thing is done, that's the progress everybody, including us, wants to hear about. But we have documented the problem a lot, and we're working with people who submitted their data to us through the forums so that we can test against live accounts. And, you know, Microsoft's engineers are working on it. Our production team is working on it. I know it's a major drag, but please do not buy anything twice. I actually did that for a couple of my songs accidentally as I was trying to figure out what I could download and what I couldn't. But that's still actively going on. Believe me, nobody wants that problem gone more than I do. There's a similar issue this week on PS4 in Europe where they Sony added about 30 new tracks, which is great, and then you cannot download them for free on PS4 right now. That's not the way it's supposed to work. You know from the previous stuff, from the previous songs that are up there, that if you bought it, then you can download it for free on PS4 and it works just fine. So not really sure what happened there, but that's been reported, so we're talking to Sony. There's never a dull moment in the life of a Rocksmith engineer, so we're working on figuring out all of these problems with our partners, and hopefully I'll have some good news for you soon, but didn't want to leave that, you know, unspoken so that anybody would think that we're trying to avoid it. We're really not trying to avoid it. We're just trying to fix it.
We've got everything to gain and nothing to lose by fixing it.
That's right.
Is what I like to say.
Yeah, like somebody who actually said, oh, you guys stole my DLC money and ran. And I'm like, that's not what we want to do at all. Like, we want you to play the song. It's like, that was the point. If we're not bank robbers or crying.
Although you could be.
Yeah, if you got like one of those domino masks and a bag of a sack of money with a dollar bill sign on the side. Yeah, Jared McAdams, is that what you're going to do for Halloween this year? Is you're going to go for an old-timey bank robber from a Little Rascals short?
Oh, I like it. Maybe you can be like Mr. Moneybags.
Why are you taking that off?
Because I can't, like, when there's like a little delay between what I'm
just
saying.
Just do the one-ear thing, man. Be like the cool kids.
This is pretty cool what I'm doing right here.
All right, yeah, well,
this is like a Darth Vader kind of thing.
It is, yeah.
I feel like it's not that bad.
Yeah.
It kind of...
You feel like...
I feel many
things.
Give me
evidence, man.
Who told you to have feelings, Brian Pody? Welcome to the show.
My wife asks occasionally.
So you guys are doing Soundgarden's. Oh, wait. I'm sorry. We forgot to do the giveaway. Everybody out there is probably freaking out because they want the giveaway. Now this is Anthony's big challenge. Can Anthony make the base pack appear on the screen that you could win? Here we go.
He's new at this.
Oh, there it is. Yes, 100% success rate
well done.
With his first trial. So this is what you can win. Our friends at Ernie Ball have sent us a whole bunch of swag, and we're sending that on to you. That's two sets of strings for your bass. If you play bass, you know you really don't have to change them all that often, and they very rarely break unless you're doing really funky tunings. But we're going to give you some regular Slinkies and some Slinky Cobalts, which are really good for you aggressive players that like more of a high-output thing. The Cobalts are really snappy and bright. And then, of course, all the other stuff that I can't talk about because I don't remember what it was. You get a strap, you get some Rocksmith picks, you get some Ernie Ball picks, and you get the wonderful Wonder Wipes, of course, to keep your guitar less janky. Because
too small a peg winder, right?
And you also get a peg winder. Thank you. Yeah. See, Anthony jumped the gun, but he's new. It's all right. He'll get it. You wait until Dan's done giving his whole advertising spiel, and then you switch off a camera. How you guys feel about doing the next song, which is...
Fell on Black Days.
That's correct. You this, read very well. You're
you.
Now reading at a fourth grade level. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The spelling bee is going to be difficult.
Oh, I'm only on the spelling A.
You have kids, right? They must eat that up. They love the dad jokes.
I'm working on it. It's an acquired skill.
What do we need to know about Fell on Black Days before we get into this, Mr. Brian Pody, who tracked the song?
I feel like Chris Cornell writes some pretty cool riffs.
But in this case,
yeah, that was almost like a
on this day he failed. No, it's good because this song really makes use of one riff a lot. It's mostly based on just the same riff and some variations of it. And then the solo is a number of notes played very quickly.
Is it because that it sounds like the main riff is pretty approachable and yet the solo now sounds complicated? Is it acceptable for newbies? Is it something that like you feel like you can get 80% of the song and then go back and work on the solo if you're interested in learning it? Or
yeah, definitely. The main riff is pretty approachable and you get the opportunity to play it many times, which is nice. You get to work on it.
Repetition is not a bad thing.
The solo makes use of a lot of square patterns, so you know they're. They're good to know, and this is a good opportunity to play them quickly.
Square, when you say square, you mean like the boxy pentatonic kind of...
Yeah, yeah.
That kind
and,
of thing.
You know, square, like...
Square, like...
Like Elsa.
Like, like, cut it out, like that kind of thing.
All right. Let's do Fell on Black Days. I'll check into the chat a little bit, and I see that there's that Black Widow is handling the raffle for everyone. We will be giving away a very similar looking guitar pack as well later on in the show. For those of you who play guitar and not bass, don't worry, we have not forgotten you, nor has our friends at Ernie Ball. And of course, coming up next on our giveaway extravaganza, we will actually have some Soundgarden DLC for Steam players to give away. So we're going to get into Fell on Black Days. Thanks for joining us. If you're just tuning in, this is the weekly Rocksmith 2014 live stream with the developers from the folks that make the game at Ubisoft Studio SF. Kill Switch Kids. Asks a good question. You guys ever have the actual artist come in and track the songs? Because they're out being rock stars. I always used to think that was how it worked in the guitar magazines, too. When I was, my first job out of college was at some of the guitar magazines in New York City, Guitar World and the dearly departed Country Guitar Magazine. And I thought for sure that, like, you know, when they did a ZZ Top song, Billy Gibbons was just stopping by the office and showing them, put your pinky there, man, and you got the groove. That's not how it works. In the entire time that I worked at Guitar World, not only did Billy Gibbons only stop by the office once, but, and I hid. I was so afraid. I was so scared. I love ZZ Top, and I was just like, I was so nervous that he was in the office that I was just like, I'm going to sit here and do work, and I was an idiot. If Billy Gibbons ever walks into your office, say hello. Apparently he's a very nice guy, and I just was so nervous I didn't know what to say to him. But of all of the things that the transcribers of the guitar magazines did, only one of them was actually ever sent in while I was there by the artist himself, and that was Dave Matthews, who said, I'll show you how to play it. And he sent in the stuff. Everything else is talented musicians like the ones you're seeing here, reverse engineering the songs. So, you know, what can you do with a music degree? This. Sorry to disappoint you. That's a good question, Lil Cook. Thanks. I think that probably a lot of people wonder that kind of stuff. Bitspiel is still talking about why we haven't updated. Oh, I'll shut up.
as advertised, solo with a lot of notes in it. Sorry, Vince Peale was asking if we're ever going to update the original Rocksmith because, you know, the note detection isn't where he wants it to be and all that stuff. No, that's why we made Rocksmith 2014. We took all the good ideas and everything that everybody learned from the original Rocksmith, and you will find better note detection now. You will find a looser tuner, anyway. You will find a whole bunch of new things that you can do. The game recognizes different guitar techniques that the original does not. Instead of patching the original game, they just built a new one because you get to a certain point where that makes more sense. So no, you should not expect any future updates to the original Rocksmith. That's kind of sunsetted, and we're putting all of our efforts into this one. I didn't see that chart at Brian Pody. Are you muted? Yeah, I don't want to hear from you anyway.
There's many things I may or may not have played that were...
That was a hell of a solo. And look, like, you guys are like, oh, man, oh, maybe I didn't do it all right. 95, 96. You guys.
It's all right.
You got nothing to... No, I'm saying that's wonderful. That's beautiful. Most songs that I play, I get like 85,
there's,
you know?
There's very nice, you know, of you to say. A possibility of 110, though.
There yeah. is. This is a good thing to bring up because this comes up
a lot
every week on Facebook or on Twitter. I actually had somebody sort of write in and say, 100.3%? Well done, you. Be way to do math. And I'm like, well, actually, that means you're so awesome that you're above 100%. So 100% is playing the song correctly. 110%. Or anything in between means that you're going into master mode. So you, when you enter master mode, the notes will start to fade out. And this is so that you get that same feeling that you get when you're learning to ride a bike and suddenly you realize that dad's not pushing you anymore. Like, this is, no, really, you know how to play this song for real. You don't need to look at the screen. Go for it. And that's how you sort of make that leap from internalizing what you're seeing to what your fingers and your brain already know how to do. So every time that you do something super accurately and you move into master mode is going to be that over 100%. So it's not an error in the game. I have never seen anybody get 110%. I don't know. I mean, it's mathematically possible. I don't know if it's actually possible. I see a lot of 103s. I have seen 105. And I was like, holy cow, you got 106?
Yeah.
Well, that's because you work here, man. You got the cheat button. It just adds like 30%, right?
That's true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so that's what that's all about. So don't think your Rocksmith is broken. It's not. You're just that good. And actually, I wrote back to the guy. I was like, where did you math? And I was like, no, you're just that good. They're like, oh, okay, well, that's pretty cool. So the key to fighting back on the internet is being a nice guy, apparently. Anything that you want to note about any of this song now that I'm done telling stories? I have nothing to do with anything at all.
I'm wondering, Jared, do you want to talk about the bass part at all? Because it's pretty cool, and it's actually kind of varied.
It's very fun to play, and it is cool. It's cool how he kind of, without changing the underlying what's going on in the riff, plays some different variations of it. He plays a part that's kind of more melodic and filling in with some scalar patterns, and then toward the end, of course, he plays with the power chords that really beefs it up for a big mm-hmm. finish. But you tracked it, man. What do you got to say about it?
I didn't look at the bass part recently. I heard
me
you.
Me neither.
I heard you playing it. And I was like, oh yeah, the bass part on this
stuff
is really
in
cool.
There. It's really fun to play. And some of the songs that I think are most fun to play, especially on bass, are things that aren't really finger flingers where you're all over the place, but it's definitely got a deep groove,
yeah.
And you just fall into it and stay in there and really lock in with the drums. But even within that, I mean, that's what's cool in this song is that it does have a significant amount of variation. And then during the solo, I'm sure nobody was looking at the bass chart during that, but there's a couple of cool little fills where it kind of goes up the neck and sort of punctuates at the ends of phrases, and also very, very tasteful, you know, not getting in the way of the guitar, waiting mm-hmm. for those moments where the guitar is kind of at the end of a phrase and adding a little something in there. So it's good stuff.
Yeah. Cool.
All right.
Would you like to win Fall on Black Days and perhaps the other four songs from the Soundgarden pack?
I would.
We'll do that. Well, okay. I will hook you up
because you're special. But out there in the internet land,
where they aren't special,
where you're not special at all, you're not. You're identical snowflakes.
You know who you are.
No, there's a guy out there. His band is called Identical Snowflakes.
I like that.
We're gonna give away while we do this little break. We're gonna take a break. I'm gonna blow my nose, and we're gonna give away 5 Steam codes, and each of those Steam codes is good for all 5 songs. So I will leave it now to Black Widow to take that away and take a look at our lessons. Hopefully, you're not just playing Rocksmith to learn new songs. Hopefully. You are taking advantage of these sort of interactive lessons that walk you through the core techniques that will make all of your songs, you'll be able to play all of those songs better. So Jared McAdams here will come to you through the magic of video and explain how the lessons work in Rocksmith 2014, and we'll be back with Smoke on the Water after this. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.
Rocksmith is designed to be a top-to-bottom guitar learning experience. We've got great ways for you to learn songs, but at some point we have to show you how to play bends, how to play the slides, how to play these basic things that you're going to play in all the songs. So that's what lessons are for. We wanted the experience with lessons to be very personal. If you're just starting guitar, then you'll be able to get instructions on how to hold it, how to put on your strap, how to play a single note. If you're a pretty advanced guitarist, then you'll be able to learn really advanced techniques like tapping and pinch harmonics. With Rocksmith 1, we really just scratched the surface with a basic introduction to a basic technique. With Rocksmith 2014, we really wanted to break things down more from the very beginning to very advanced applications of each technique. There are more than 80 lessons covering topics for guitar and bass and extra things like tuning and alternate tunings and how to take care of your equipment. We really wanted to boost up the feeling of interactivity with the lessons this time around. So you're not just watching a video and then parroting what you see in the video and then you're on your own. You are watching a video to get the basics, and then we're going to listen to you play and we're going to give you instant feedback about how you're doing. We're not just saying you did it wrong, we're saying here's what you need to do to fix what you're doing wrong. I get to see a knowledgeable player actually playing the technique correctly. So here's a note and I'm going to try to play it.
I think you're on the wrong string there.
So it's not just telling me I'm wrong, it's saying, oh, you're on the wrong string. Well, let me get on the right string.
You don't need to bend it quite that far. You've got the right idea.
So it's telling me not just that I'm doing something wrong, it's telling me what I need to do to correct my technique. Okay, so right string, right fret, right place. Let's bend it the right amount.
Yeah, that was good.
And I go on to the next video. We also felt that it was really important to present each technique in a musical context. Every lesson comes with a practice track that teaches you how to play that technique in the course of a song. You're always in control. You can skip ahead, skip back, replay a section, replay a video, replay one of the riffs. With lessons in Rocksmith 2014, you're not just learning to play a game, you're learning to play music.
Hey everybody, welcome back to the Rocksmith 2014 stream. So eagle-eyed viewers will notice two things. One, this is not the people that were up here before. Hi, Greg Barr. Hi, Brian McCune. How are you doing?
Great. How are you?
I'm going to sneeze on you and you'll find out just how I am. Yeah. but eagle-eyed viewers will also notice that the guitar Greg is holding is the same one from the video you just didn't watch because you ran away to get a drink and you were so interested in entering the raffle that you didn't listen to anything that Jared said. We know. He's hurt, but I'll console him later. Yeah, that's our house Epiphone Sheridan 2, right? Sheridan 2? I know it's a Sheridan. I think it's a Sheridan 2.
It is a Sheridan.
It is a Sheridan 2. So yes, many of the guitars that you see in our ads and in our training videos and things like that are actually property of the studio. We bought a bunch. We, you know,
we do that from time to time. And you got a lovely guitar for yourself just a couple of months ago. I posted some pictures of it in our forums at rocksmith.ubi.com if you want to see. You got an Epiphone Riviera P93, right?
So it has three P90s.
Three
That's
P90s
awesome
and gold hardware and a Bigsby.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's very pretty.
How's
it's
that
a lot
working
of stuff.
For you?
That's why I bought it. I'm like, it, you know,
it's the kind of thing that's
crappy
like,
guitar, but has the most stuff on it.
But if you see that in somebody's house or on the wall, you go, oh, they must really know what they're doing.
Yeah, I look like a baller now.
Nobody knows that. You know, you could be the worst. So if you want to impress people and make them think that you know how to play guitar, Epiphone Riviera P93, mm-hmm. Check it out. It's good. Are you enjoying it? Are you having fun
it's
with
good.
It?
It's good. Yeah, I played it at the New Year's gig we just had. And
oh, great!
It actually plays really nice.
What's your band?
What's your band? Let's get a plug for your band.
The Gentlemen Amateurs is the name of the band, and we do. Like Motown, R&B, soul.
Wrong one. Use the other.
Take this one off.
Yeah, you should take that one off. That would be much better.
Like Motown, R&B, dance music stuff, and yeah. And I played that guitar for the gig, and it just made
no
it
problems
more
with the Bigsby
classy.
Live.
No, and I actually restrung it too. And you said it was going to be the
I
hardest
said it was
thing
in
the
be
world.
Hell, yeah.
It really wasn't that hard. You just gotta clamp the ball end of the
right.
string. You just gotta twist it so it doesn't fall off.
Oh, all right.
But it's not too bad.
All right, teach me, Obi-Wan. Okay. Show me next time you change strings. And hi, Brian McCune. How you doing?
Hi. I don't have a new guitar.
No, but you have a lovely collection of sweaters.
I do.
You have some great sweaters.
Yeah.
And every day you come in wearing another like really distinctive, interesting, warm, fuzzy looking sweater.
Yeah.
Congratulations on that.
Thank you very much for the comment on my sweater collection.
You're the Dr. Huxtable of our office,
I think. Thank you. That's what I'm going for.
You have excellent sweaters.
I was going for a Fred Rogers, but that's
all right. I actually found myself doing that. I came home and I took off my hoodie and I put on like another hoodie, like a little sweater kind of hoodie. Yeah. And I just looked at my wife and I went, oh, no. She goes, it's all right. It's fine. It's, you know. But yeah, you're like, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. So anyway, that's not why we're here. Thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the stream, we have recently changed our time, so we may have some new folks. Hi, I'm Dan Amrick. I'm the community developer for Rocksmith 2014, which means when you yell at us on Twitter, you're yelling at me. And what we do every week is we try to give a spotlight to some of our DLC, both old and new, in this live stream. We are coming to you live from San Francisco in the Ubisoft offices, very close to AT&T Park. Every once in a while, baseball flies through the window, and we do that like angry neighbor thing where it hits the
shrink ray, and then we're all really small. After
that's exactly what happens. But what we do every week, in addition to giveaways of Ernie Ball, we have some more Ernie Ball stuff to give away a little bit later in the show. And run-throughs of this week's DLC, which happens to be Soundgarden, as I'm sure you figured out by the giant logo behind my head. We also do something that we call the Backtrack Spotlight. Once a week, one of our note trackers will break down sort of the music theory or the technique or something interesting that's going on under the hood of some of the songs that are already in the game. They're generally songs that you know, and maybe you didn't know this stuff about them. And this week, we chose Deep Purple's classic Smoke on the Water, one of the first songs that a lot of guitarists figure out on their own, just that basic riff because it's very approachable.
And for some time, it was the first note track that note trackers would work on.
This was the test kit?
Yeah, in a way. It was a way to see how you would level it, how good are your transcription skills. So there are many different early iterations of this.
Of Smoke on the Water.
From like 2010.
Wow. Yeah. So how many people failed the Smoke on the Water test?
No, I don't think anybody really failed it. Actually, a few people did fail it at the beginning. I think a lot of people transcribed it down here.
Right.
As a single note line, I was like, wait a second. This is definitely in fourths and an octave higher. So
if you don't know what that means, you should probably go to our forum and read the background. Greg, you actually wrote up this week's backtrack.
And I didn't fail the test, by the way.
Good for you.
No.
Failed every other test.
Hasn't done anything right since.
Right.
But gosh darn it, he made Smoke on the Water work.
He has to take the bus to work. Yeah.
Right.
Can't drive.
What's the core thrust? Hopefully people will go to the forums at rocksmith.com and check it out. But what's the sort of the overall? You talked a little bit about the simplicity of the song and how it shouldn't work, and yet it does. And the simplicity is kind of what gives the song its power. Is that
fair
to say?
I mean, it's based on the G minor blues scale, the whole thing, which is kind of the first scale that all guitarists learn, usually. That was the pentatonic, but...
He failed again. Did you notice that?
That was good. So the blues scale just has one more note. that one. So the whole thing is, and that
hitting
is
that
the
blue
note
is what gives it that tension
exactly.
and makes it really memorable.
Mm-hmm.
But it's exactly. a double blue note because it's also harmonized down the fourth.
And it's also harmonized a fourth. So between the D and G strings, this is a fourth, and then you just keep that on those same two strings, barring the same frets, and then you're harmonizing every note in perfect fourths. And it lays out really well on the guitar because it's just all the same fret.
Sure.
Yeah.
All and right.
The solo's mostly in G minor blues as well.
Do you want to play it for us?
I will.
That didn't sound like you wanted to. You just said you would. Do you want to? I will. Oh, okay. So Greg's going to play Smoke on the Water. You're going to play bass on this?
I'm going to play bass on it. It's unrelenting, especially in the middle section. Anybody who's played it on the bass path knows that it just starts moving all around, doesn't repeat, and you're just chase the eighth note.
Wow. Okay. Yeah.
It's a lot harder than you think it would be.
I was going to say, with a very basic guitar riff, you think, like, oh, no, but then that gives the bassist freedom to move.
No, the verses are straightforward. You got that. That's pretty easy.
Right. I can play that.
Yeah. Even Dan can have success.
All right, so let's. I thought you were going to follow up with a secondary insult, and I was going to take it like a good sport. But we'll do Smoke on the Water. I'll check in on the chat and stick around because we do have some more Ernie Ball stuff to give away, plus some more Soundgarden DLC that we'll be playing live as well. Rekus says it would be nice to be able to change the string colors. Well, that would kind of defeat the design purpose of the string colors. If you would like to change the string colors, go into the options. Yeah, you're a little bit out of tune. Yeah, so I was going to say, which one is it? Can you reach over and tweak it for him?
Better.
This is what it's like to work at Studio SF. Everybody has a musical ear. And we're... Do you want to stop? Why do you stop? Holy cow. Everybody in the room is cringing because everybody's really sensitive to that.
It's really hard for me to hear.
Well, no, also, this room is usually super cold, and there's so many different microclimates within the Ubisoft office. Like, we work in a lot of old buildings, beautiful old historic buildings, but the temperature is all over the place depending on where you are.
And once you add bodies to the room, too.
Right, we added bodies, and then we turn on the lights, and Jared brought in some extra lights today. So anything
I blame Jared's heat lamps that he got from the Tennessee Black Market.
No, the heat lamps are great.
chicken in Boston Market.
Yeah, this sweater is not helping right now.
I was going to say, you're regretting that sweater now. Even
should we give it another shot?
Let's give it another shot.
All right.
Thank you for correcting that. Keep in mind that you can always do that too, folks. You can pause any song, stop, double-check your tuning, restart the song. Hey, that sounds beautiful now. Thank you. But that's the nature of instruments made out of wood, you know? Like, the wood expands and contracts, and if you're outside, you take your guitar in on a cold day into a warm room, even if it's been in a case, you need to give it 15, 30 minutes to acclimate to that thing because the tuning's going to be all wacky, and some people will say longer. And you need to do what? And it might check your paint. That's right. The finish, extreme temperature swings can affect your finish and make it all crackly, which some people really like. But I like everything shiny. Oh, that's right. Squirrely Ninja points out that Rolling Stone used to be in these offices. So we have a rock history here. That's kind of nice. This name is lame has a specific question. Maybe you can handle this, but this is kind of what Brian was talking about before. Doesn't this sound better if you play it on the A and the D string fretted in place of the open notes? I'm going to hand the mic to Jared and have him pontificate on this.
I'm going to run the mic like a man. We were having conversations about exactly this, Brian McCune and I, just the other day. And, there are a few different places on the guitar neck where you can play this riff. You can play it as suggested in the chat on the fourth and fifth strings,
You can also play it on the fifth and sixth strings, on the low strings, up the neck, in like, I guess, eighth position or whatever it is. Which I've seen Ritchie Blackmore do that in concert footage, but I've also seen him play it in the lower position. So back in the day, it wasn't my chart. I wasn't around for that one, so I don't know how it ended up getting tracked this stupid way. I think this is probably right. I know that that Brian had some thoughts on that. But I think that this is probably the way it's played on the recording. That's the best evidence we have.
We always try to get the actual recording whenever humanly possible. Because that's what you're used to hearing, and we're trying to teach you the techniques that the actual artists are playing. I do have another interesting question from Unleash2K. He's been apparently asking a lot, and I kept missing every time you brought it up. Have you ever had to modify the game to add support for something in a song, such as a technique or a song, or a technique or a tone? If song, which if so, which song is most notable for the biggest addition in the game? I think really that goes back to the jump from RS1 to RS2014. There were a whole bunch of techniques that were not supported. What were some of the techniques that RS1 did not support that came in with 2014? Interesting. I didn't throw the mic back to Jared, but palm mutes, fret hand mutes, that was also... You had palm mutes in the first one, but not fret hand mutes. Jared was saying one of the biggest things that came in with 2014 was how the game detects bends. String bending used to be a very binary thing. It was either on or off. Did you bend the string? Yes? Okay, then you pass. And one of the things, the refinements that they added with 2014 was to tell you where you should start and end those bends on the fretboard. So that's something. But yeah, on a per-song basis, are we adding things to the engine or the note detection system? No, generally not, because that's the kind of thing that can really break a game. So that's like a big overhaul. The jump from the original game to 2014 was where they did a lot of that stuff, where they looked at how can we offer more detailed techniques. That said, in terms of tones, we've seen Brendan West, our tone chaperone, do a whole hell of a lot of interesting things with emulating real-world effects with digital things, that stuff that guys might use a special pedal for that we might not do, or a kill switch. What was the thing he just did recently that like he had to switch? That was just like amps falling from the sky over and over and over again. Oh, Enemies by Shinedown, right? Yeah.
And some Rage stuff.
Some Rage stuff, yeah. There was some really tricky stuff in Rage.
Yeah, to emulate the wah.
Yeah, so rather than reprogramming the game, our folks are finding creative solutions within the tools that we have so that we don't break anything even further. I didn't mean to step all over your beautiful solo.
Wasn't that great, to be honest.
Well, your humility is noted, but for crying out loud.
Yeah, I had something interesting happen that hasn't
What did you do? Did
before.
You cut yourself?
I'm double jointed and my pinky locked, and I couldn't play those bass notes after
is that
a while.
What happened? Okay.
Yeah, and those
so
double jointed phrases.
How do you undo that? Do you just like pull
I just
it
had
yank?
To like take my hand
yeah,
away
me,
and lock it. Yeah.
Wow.
And break my pinky real quick. Yeah.
That's bizarre.
Yeah, it was weird. It didn't feel good either.
There you go. We have mutants working here. Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
Anything you want to add other than what you've talked about?
You guys were talking about the different positions. So last part, I actually did play it up here, which I think is the position you were talking about. And, I mean, it totally passes in the game because the game is only pitch sensitive. So if you want to put in the extra legwork and you can figure out, okay, what are these notes? What's this note? Where else can I find it on the neck? And actually just use your ear, find the note, find the other note, and figure out the guitar yourself. You don't need to do everything the game says. Sometimes you can take it offline
explore the space.
Exactly, yeah. And yeah. Get to know the guitar and get to know music.
When I did this chart, I actually had it transcribed as a fifth down the fret. Not up in that position, but I did, instead of the two open strings, I did a double step
on
the fifth fret.
You can also do that. These two notes.
And that's how I did it. But for learning, it just kind of made sense. Keep everything on one string. Mm-hmm. And the way the level design worked is you could learn the riff on one string and then add in the double stops. So it was an intentional design decision. There are many ways to play the same thing.
Sure. I mean that's kind of what Greg is saying, too. There are many ways to play. You're going to find the same note in like four different places on the neck. You know, sometimes it's about efficiency, sometimes it's about tonality. But if you want to sort of mix it up, that's okay. Game's not going to tell you you're a terrible person for coloring outside the lines. When you color outside the lines on guitar, that's called jazz. So
yeah, I was just watching Jason Kokel's performance of Cliffs of Dover,
right.
And he does things differently than Eric Johnson does. He plays open strings instead of doing a different fingering. I was watching Nick Smith online doing the same piece, and he put things in a lower position sometimes to make it easier. So make it your own. I mean, that's kind of the fun of musical expression.
I have nothing to say. That was just so beautiful.
And it also, I mean, it depends physically on your hands as well and just the way you learned and your technique. Some people only use three fingers, which is technically wrong, but a lot of people do that. And so they play.
Django Reinhardt only used two.
That wasn't a choice.
Yeah. But yeah, however you want to do it. If it's Eddie Van Halen always used to say, if it sounds good, it is good. Like there's this apocryphal story. I don't know if it's really true, but he got in trouble in a class for not playing this piano piece right, and he looked at the class and he goes, I'm going to play it his way and then I'm going to play it my way, and you tell me which way you should do it should be done. And they gave him a standing ovation. So he said, handed him the books at sea and walked out. Now, I don't know. If you're Eddie Van Halen, maybe you can get away with that. But that's sort of like, that's the extremely arrogant way that proves what we're talking about here, which is, you know, if it sounds good, it is good. And if you found a different way to do it, that's okay. Use it. It's totally fine. Don't be so hung up on, but I didn't get 100% in the song. It's about playing the song, not scoring the song. It is, at least it is for me. I don't know about you guys. All right. Get the hell out of my stools. Thank you for joining. we do have a little bit of time for Q&A, and I promised you guys that if you gave us some Q&A time, if you gave us some questions, we would attempt to tackle it. I'm going to switch over to one of the stools, so if somebody else wants to sit in on the host thing and look at the chat, you're certainly welcome to do so. I'm looking at Jared since I don't know if you're comfortable doing it. You love the attention, man.
To be on camera,
here,
man.
You go take that, and then we'll. Yes, so I'm going to be playing on this one too, and I should probably grab a bass.
Here it is.
No,
hey, everybody.
I'm playing my bass.
What song are we doing?
Well, we're going to do the last of the Soundgarden songs. Here, why don't you have the
last of the three.
Yes, the last of the three that we're doing this week. There are five in the pack, so if you
I've
buy the pack.
I've heard of this one.
Have you? That's good.
Yeah.
I had heard of all of them, I'm happy to say. Yeah, I think everybody's heard of this one.
This is a well-known song.
This is a well-known song, and of course, as usual, I got to play it like twice, and then I didn't practice anymore because I just didn't have time. It's been one of those weeks. Come on. Tuned, darn you.
You know the old saying, practice makes you tired.
That's true. Early to bed and early to rise makes a man exhausted, too. That's, I believe, there's probably many other cliches we could destroy if we tried really hard. Hi, Sam Schwartz.
What's up, man?
How you doing, man? Hey, should I be playing this with a pick or with fingers?
It's up to you.
Per our earlier thing, whatever you want to do, man, that's cool.
You want to play
but I always
shooting.
Do try to play whatever the actual artist does. Although I vastly prefer playing bass with a pick. I know that that's heresy to a lot of people because they feel like bass is just better with fingerstyle, but I like playing with a pick.
I think it really depends.
But they're different sounds.
I mean?
How do they're you want it to
sounds.
Sound? You don't
right.
necessarily always want it to sound
I guess
way.
Here it's like Black Hole Sun, that's the song. Sorry, everybody. Way to spoil the rig reveal.
I quit!
The ability to do it with fingers does give you a little bit more of a mellower tone, which I think serves the song. But something like punk, you know, or something really high energy, then you are going to want to pick for that extra attack, and it's going to make a big difference in how it feels. I always try to follow the game's advice. And by the way, if you're playing on PS4, you will have noticed that that's new in the patch. That was something that got that wasn't there when the game launched, but now when you play a bass song in single player, learn a song, it will recommend whether you play it with pick or fingers. But again, it's a recommendation; it's not a rule.
Yeah, I mean, my default is usually to play with a pick,
right?
Unless the song really, really calls for it.
You find any questions? I didn't actually look for any questions.
You know, one here is it is there a way to have the backing instruments play continuously in session mode, because it's hard to get going sometimes when you have to generate noise to keep it going.
Right. I don't believe there is.
I do think sometimes calibrating can help with that. Sometimes if you're not well calibrated, the game doesn't think you're playing as loud as you actually are, and it kind of jumps the gun on backing off. But there's no way to sort of override it and say, hey,
just keep on trucking.
Yeah. But you know, there is some flexibility built into the system, so it's going to keep going for a while. It won't just like stop on a dime. And if you're seeing like it stops on a dime and it's really jumping the gun and it's supposed to sort of go into a lull and wait for you to pick back up and then join you when you do. If it's not doing that, you might want to calibrate.
True. And for what it's worth, there is a replay. There's a highlight here on our Twitch channel of Nick Bedarnity talking about session mode. He's one of the main guys that was the architect on session mode. It's really his baby. But he admits it's a 1.0 product, right? This is the first time session mode was not in the original Rocksmith. It's something that's new for 2014.
New for the universe.
New for the universe, because there's really nothing like this out there. He obviously, we have things that we've learned and things that, oh, you know, what if you could do this? And you know, it would be great to do this. And of course, all of your suggestions as well. So who knows what the future will bring. But those kind of suggestions are always worth voicing, because we are keeping track of them. We don't know whether we're going to get a chance to do another Rocksmith anytime soon. But if we do, those are the kind of things like, well, what do you want to do? Do we want to bring session mode back? If so, what do we want to do better? And that's really where those discussions start. So. Yeah.
One more thing that it might be worth having you speak to. What's the latest on Xbox One DLC situation?
Yes, that's from somebody who must have come in halfway through, because I did address this earlier in the stream. So right now, we've been speaking with Microsoft. Even within this last week, we've been talking with Microsoft and trading data and saying, well, here's what we've seen, and here's the numbers on our end. Here's the data. Here's the ID of the things that are not connecting correctly. And they went, huh, all right. We'll get back to you. So that's where we are now, is where we are sort of trading emails with Microsoft saying, can you test this? Can you give me this information? The situation for people that do not play on Xbox platforms, any DLC that you bought on 360 is supposed to be downloadable for free on Xbox One. That was one of our promises at launch. And that turned out to be way harder and not working the way that it was supposed to. We had a roadmap and we did everything, and then just didn't work. So we're still untangling that with Microsoft. I don't have an ETA for you, and I don't have sort of like the answer that we all want to hear, which is it's fixed. You know, I want to give you that answer more than anybody, because I'd really like to think about other things involving the Rocksmith community other than just answering that question over and over again. Yes, you deserve it. Yes, this should have been fixed. No, it's not fixed. Yes, that's the reality. Yes, I'll let you know as soon as I know of anything else. But just because you don't see the answer doesn't mean that there isn't progress being made behind the scenes. I know a lot of people are like, we haven't heard anything. It's like, well, you've heard, like, we don't have any update.
Yeah. But every time Dan's typing the update, he's not, you know, working on the problem.
Right. Well, and I actually have done an awful lot, and the community has really helped us with this. We asked people for lists of songs, you know, what are you able to get, what are you not able to get, and then we cross-reference that with other users, and we sent all of that data off to Microsoft. Thankfully, Sharon cleaned it all up before it actually went out, so it makes sense to other people, but, you know, we're trying to solve this with you. It is the nature of a live product. Like, you know, you buy a can of beans. If there's no beans inside, then you can just take it back and get another can of beans. That's not the way the software works. It's like, hey, we're live. It's up and running. And, oh, God, that's not working. And what you're seeing is people try to solve it in real time. So it's just the nature of the beast. That's what software is. So I wish I had better news for you, but please don't think that we've given up on you. Certainly, I haven't given up on myself because I'm an Xbox 360 owner, and that's my primary platform for playing Steam with my wife. And we're like, can we play? I'm like, no, that song's not in there yet. You know, so hang in there. All I'm asking for is your patience. As soon as I have good news, I will be shouting it from the rooftops. But, you know. Can't promise what I don't have.
Yeah. Well, do we want to continue?
No more questions. Well, no, you can do it. If there's one more easy question, let's.
Well, one thing that it might be worth speaking to is why A445? Why would we ever choose to put something in such a funky tuning?
Let's talk about this.
Sam, you actually tracked this song, right?
This song. So we were realizing. So a lot of times when we get songs, we'll. Oh, sorry.
Yeah.
There we go.
There it is.
So a lot of times when we're tracking a song, we'll get an option to use, like, we'll request from the licensor, hey, can we pitch shift the song down to E standard, right? So
right.
That we can, you know, or to A440. You know, when we have a song like this, we'll request it. And sometimes it makes sense to do it. And this particular case, it's so much more that it would have sounded very strange pitch shifting it. And people will be like, that's not the version of the song that I know.
Right.
There's a really good point, and I think Jason Kokel brought it up in a meeting once, and it was like, well, when I was a kid and I had to learn these songs, I had to tune my guitar so that it sounded right.
Yeah.
And back in my day. But that's kind of part of what it is, you know. It's like this is a real instrument, you know, and it's why you get to feel that huge reward of playing the song, because you had to tune your guitar, you had to listen, you had to do that, and as opposed to us sort of doing all the work for you, still you got to work for it, you know,
right,
at the end of the day. And I think that's part of the beauty of Rocksmith, right? I mean, so.
But we didn't do that on the original game, right? Like on Rocksmith 1, there's a lot of like 444.
On Rocksmith 1, we couldn't do it.
Oh.
We didn't have the option. And we only had E standard and drop D. So one of the big things that the note trackers would have to do anytime we were thinking about a song was to go through it and say and decide, does this fit our tuning requirements? And if it didn't,
and we just couldn't request it.
An option. Like, there were just all those songs were just off the table.
Wow.
Anything that was in a different tuning, anything that was not A440, or there might have been a couple of cases I don't remember where it was a little off, and we said, well, I guess it's close enough, and it just kind of sounds off.
Right.
and any time we came across something like that, we fixed it when we upgraded for 2014.
Yeah, and it's one of those things where, you know, we have to make that judgment call, and Anthony and Brian are doing a lot of the negotiation with licensing, but what it comes down to, when we make a decision like this, it's like, well, is it going to be the song that you're familiar with? Because the whole point of playing the tune is to be able to feel like you're playing that
right.
song that you
it's
love.
What you know.
And if it's a pitch shifted song that's like almost a half step down or a quarter step down or a quarter step up or something, it's going to sound funky if it's the right kind of tune.
Yeah.
You know?
I mean, there are times where it would just be too much of a change to the song. And when that's the case, the licensor just won't let us do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, if we go to them, and there are cases where it's not even a huge change, but they're like, no, this is the song. It is sacrosanct, and you may not edit, you may not pitch shift, you may not do anything. And in those cases, our options are to have the pitch offset or not use the song.
Yep. Fair enough. Now you know the secret behind the little numbers underneath the tuning. It's not arbitrary, and we are trying to make it as convenient as possible, but hey, you got to respect the original material too. Mm-hmm. Speaking of the original material, what do you say we do the last song, and then we'll do our last giveaway right after the last song. We have the Ernie Ball bass pack. But let's dive into Black Hole Sun and see me fail, because I'm really not practiced up on this. And I probably will stop my snappy patter during this because I'm going to have to pay attention.
Oh, the first part of this, for people who are attempting this lead chart, we figured out that the first part is actually played with an e-bow. So, which
that's
is why. Yeah.
Can you explain what an e-bow is?
Yeah, so an e-bow, I think maybe Pody can explain this better than I can, but an e-bow is a little gadget that you have, and it hovers over your strings, and it makes them resonate. And I'm not sure. I think
it's magnetic feedback.
It's got a magnetic. Okay, so it's magnetic, right? Yeah.
It's basically a
speaker coil.
That's like a speaker pickup coil is what Pody is saying.
So, yeah, there's a speaker coil, and then effectively your strings become the speaker cone.
Oh,
I've
wow.
I've tried to build one.
Ah.
I've tried to build,
being the operative word,
I've tried
guessing.
To build a sustainer. It made amazing noises.
But it wasn't an Ebo.
Well, it did it. It just also, if you turned it on and you set the guitar down, it sounded like it was going to blow up because the whole instrument
oh,
would
great.
Just vibrate. So it was very powerful.
All right.
Let's play a song.
Let's do
yeah,
it.
Yeah, let's really play a song. So if you're having trouble getting the tone on the opening, that's why.
That's why.
It's not a slide. It's an Ebo.
It's not you.
It's not you. Well, it could be you.
It could be you.
But it's probably not you. All right, so Black Hole Sun by Soundgarden, one of five songs available in the Soundgarden 5-pack that's available now.
Just to clarify, they don't sign off on it after it's note tracked. They sign off on any changes we want to make to the audio before we actually lock into doing the song. Or, well, actually, sometimes we find out in the middle of tracking, like, oh, there's an issue with this, the tuning's off, or some other weird issue. But we have to get all that straightened out before everything's all the content's generated.
Bass chord.
Whoops. Bass for Losing My Religion is incredibly good. Mike Mills, the bassist of REM, is one of my favorites. Nice slide.
Yeah.
Question of online multiplayer, that's a tough nut to crack. No plans for it anytime soon. The time it takes to transfer audio data over the internet just makes it too slow to actually work. But who knows what would happen in the future. It's certainly something that people have asked for and that we would love to do if we can figure it out. But so far, nobody's figured it out. Quantum multiplayer, I like that.
Oh.
Perfect.
Beautiful.
That was
beautiful.
It. That's it.
You got it right. Yeah, don't forget all those other notes also.
There's your
you.
Percentage. It's all for nothing.
Thanks, Jared.
Nice slide.
You're welcome. Very approachable on bass. I just should have. I would have been able to do this better if I had reviewed it a little bit more. But if you're looking for an approachable bass song, it's a good one. and it's still melodic.
It's kind of a perfect bass line.
There actually is a video, audio-visual sync setting in the settings menu through the tools menu from the main menu in Rocksmith, so you can calibrate whether the visual is lining up with the audio, but that doesn't have any effect on any lag you might experience for the sound coming out of your guitar, making it out of the speakers.
Woo! That's a good one. I like it.
That is a fun song to play.
I like it.
Hey, Sam, they were asking, did you ever actually try it with an Ebo? Did you bring an Ebo in and
I don't
play
have
it.
No, I think Brendan did. Or he was
when
like...
he was working on the tone.
Yeah, because when he was working on the tone, I was... We all do this thing with Brendan because Brendan's so good at making tones that I'll sit there like for half an hour, 45 minutes, maybe an hour or something, trying to figure out something, and I'll be like, wait a minute. And then I email Brendan, and he's like, yeah, it was this. And
yeah,
I'm like, oh.
He's an encyclopedia.
I was like, I just spent an hour trying to figure out how this dude did this one thing, and it was a tone, and it
just
was...
Just ask Brendan.
Just ask Brendan, dude. Like,
usually a good policy.
Yeah, it really is.
Finger on the pulse of music.
Yeah, so that's usually how most of those things get figured out, is like, you know, if we can't figure it out, if we're not exactly sure how something like this is a situation where I was like, I'm just not sure what it was because I've only seen an Ebo like once in my whole life. You know, so that was he was like, oh yeah, it's an Ebo. I'm like, oh.
Now you know.
One more thing. Reckless Gambit asks, any more Boxsmith coming?
Oh, I would love to say yes.
Yeah, I would too.
We had a lot of fun doing Boxsmith, obviously, and hopefully you've seen some of the video documentaries, the behind-the-scenes stuff that we shot, and Jared edited, actually. The reason it looks so good is because Jared said, get rid of all this crap, just give me the good stuff, put it all together. You know what? Not right now. We don't have any immediate plans for Boxsmith, but I'll tell you this. If we ever did Boxsmith 2, it would be a surprise anyway. Like, we would want to, like... surprise you with it when we did it, but right now I can honestly say we're not tracking any new classical
songs. There's nothing
songs.
Nothing on the calendar, but it's an ongoing conversation. It's something all of us would love to do.
Oh, yeah.
We just have to work it out.
Yeah, but if you have classical pieces that you'd like to request, go ahead and do that through the request app and just put the composer down as the artist. That's bit.ly/rsrequests, and somebody in the chat room may even be helpful and put that URL in there. Hey, we've got one more thing to do before we go away, and that's give you something for free. I know that you'd like that. Here's the Ernie Ball guitar accessories pack that we're going to give away. And please notice that whereas the bass has got cobalt strings, you guitarists are getting a nice fresh pack of Slinky M Steels. These are also really good, ultra high output, it says on the screen if you can read. And yeah, so you'll get two sets of strings, plus you'll get a set of Wonder Wipes, which is a way to clean and nourish your fretboard and stuff like that. A strap, because everybody can always use an extra one of those. A peg winder, some Ernie Ball picks, and some of the very, very, very popular Rocksmith picks. So we had these printed up. These are actually pretty old. These have the Rocksmith 1 logo, so I was told you're not supposed to use those anymore. And I'm like, but we got a bag of them! So we're going to go through these until they're gone. But I generally send everybody three picks with the Rocksmith logo. And we've had people say, how do I buy them and where do I get them? And well, you only get them here. They're only here. Or if I'm lucky enough to go to a show like Penny Arcade Expo or something like that, then I generally have a pocket full of them. But yeah, so hopefully you will be the winner. Our friend Black Widow will teach you what you need to do to enter.
They're doing
that.
It right now.
They're
man.
Doing it right
it's
now
happening.
Already.
It's
boom,
happening.
It's gone. Raffle. So while you guys are tearing each other over table scraps from our friends at Ernie Ball, I'd like to say thank you for tuning in for our weekly live stream. Thank you, Jared. Thank you, Sam. Thank you, Brian Pony on the Wheels of Steel. And, of course, let's see who else was here. Anthony and Brian and David Stevens and Greg Barr. Always great to be here every week. We will be back again next week with some new DLC. The good news and the bad news is I think I figured out the puzzle for this week. So if you'd like a hint and you'd like to get in on the hunt for what we're releasing next week for DLC, DLC. Go to the Rocksmith Forum sometime tomorrow and look for the Dan's Clue thread. And maybe you want to look at some of the older clues so you can see some of my tricks and what kind of things I like to do. If you can outwit me, then you might be able to figure out what we're going to do for DLC next week before we officially announce it, which is technically Tuesday. Although we give a pretty big, obvious hint on Mondays on Facebook. So either way, we hope that we'll see you next week so that we can see some of that stuff. Thanks for your continued support and your feedback. We love you guys. We appreciate that you keep us all employed, let's face it. That's it. We're going to leave you with one more trailer look at all five of the Soundgarden songs, which are available now. These songs will be out in Europe on PS3. In February. There's a delay. There's a schedule also posted in our forums, so go check that out. If you want to know when the DLC that's coming out is scheduled in different areas of the world, there's a hiccup, and life is interesting all the time. Thanks very much for watching. Here's some Soundgarden. See you guys next week.